Here's a surprise, the Mate 9 isn't a big smartphone. The screen may be massive, but Huawei has clearly used some form of magic to squeeze it into a small body. It's shorter and the same width as the LG V20, which has a 5.7-inch screen, and just 2mm longer and 3mm wider than the 5.5-inch Pixel XL. Probably not coincidentally, it has a nearly identical footprint to the Apple iPhone 7 Plus. It sits very comfortably in your hand. Yes, you still have to stretch your thumb from one side of the screen to the other, but it's not an impossible task. It takes no more effort to do so than on normal phones like the iPhone 7 Plus or the Pixel XL. The use of on-screen Android menu keys only helps, too. Huawei smoothed the sides of the metal body, but left enough of an edge to give the phone some bite, lowering the chances of it slipping from your grip. While it's relatively compact and comfortable, it is quite heavy at 190 grams. It's a big, all-metal phone, with a very large piece of Gorilla Glass over the display, so the extra weight isn't a shock. This whopping size doesn't apply to the fingerprint sensor, which is below the camera lens on the rear. It's actually quite small and is completely obscured by my fingertip. It's no bad thing, and we can't fault the accuracy. What the Mate 9 isn't is very pretty. The design has barely changed from the Mate 8, which was a bit faceless to start with, and although the dual lens Leica camera gives it some character, the Mate 9 is all business and not much play. Software tweaks add features. Huawei has always frustrated us with its software. It covers Android in its own emotion user interface, EMUI, which in the past has been intrusive, sometimes buggy, and often awkwardly frustrating. No more so than many other third-party user interfaces, but it usually let the overall phone experience down in a way that seemed unnecessary. The Mate 9 still has EMUI, but it's version 5, and it has been refined. Huawei tells us it's the company's biggest software revision to date, with more than 400 alterations, many of which remove older elements we didn't like. The great news is it's built over Android 7.0 Nougat, and our review phone has the newest Android security patch installed, so it's about as up-to-date as Android phones can get. Huawei was always a great fan of spreading apps across multiple home screens, Apple style, rather than giving Android users an app drawer. Rejoice, Android purists, because the Mate 9 has an app drawer. It's an option hidden in the menu system, but it's there. Personally, I've never had a problem with putting apps on home screens, but having the chance to clear them, highlight key apps, and show off some cool wallpaper is great. The notification shade.